Hello friends, we are Digital World Computer and today we will learn about subquery. A subquery, query inside a query is called subquery. Why we use subquery? Here in an example of subquery. If we want to know who has a salary greater than Abel's, Abel's is the employee, then we want which employee have salary greater than Abel's salary. And the subquery is, what is the Abel's salary? Because we don't know the Abel's salary. So the first query or the main query is, which employees have salaries greater than Abel's salary? And the subquery is, what is the Abel's salary? First we find the Abel's salary, and the output of subquery is as input in the main query. And this problem is solved as subquery. Subquery is the main and important part in the SQL database. Here this is the subquery. This is the example and the query for subquery. We want to know the employee's salary greater than Abel's salary. So we have to write this main query here. This is the main query. This is the main query and this is the subquery. Here through this command we have to find the Abel's salary. Select salary from employees where last name is equal to Abel. And after the input, after the output of this subquery, this is the input for main query, like 11,000 is the output of subquery, and here it is the input for the main query. Select last name comma salary from employees where salary is greater than 11,000, and here output is King, Kochar, Dihan, Hartia, Sagis. This is the output of main query. Here you can see this, the output of main query. You can see the output of main query only. You cannot see the output of subquery because the subquery output is the input for main query. Here are the guidelines for using subqueries. First is enclosing subqueries in parentheses. It means when you are writing any subquery, then you enclose it in parentheses. Next, place subquery on the right side of the comparison condition for readability. However, the subquery can appear on either side of the comparison operator. Third one is using right row operators with single row subquery and multiple row operator with multiple row subquery. Here are two types of subqueries. First is single row subquery, that is used as main query. Subquery returns the output in a single way. Second is multiple row subquery, main query, subquery, and returns the multiple output as shown in the multiple row subquery. Here is a single row subquery. Single row only one row that is used for single row. Comparison operators are equal to, greater than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to. Here we have a query that is select salary from employees where salary is greater than select salary from employees where last name is equal to Abel's. It means we use single row subquery because it is a single output from the subquery, and we give the single output from the main query. Here when we executed this query on our command line prompt, it gives the single the output. Here you can see this. We can execute this query in another way, that we want last name also. Here you can see this, Hartin, Higgins, King, Kochar, Dihan, Greenberg, Rishil, Partners. These are the salaries which are greater than Abel's salary because Abel's salary is 11,000.
Here we are
the
using
next type of query is
in a subquery.
Multiple row subquery.
here you can see
here we have
minimum safety, that is the group or functions. Some
and this is also a single
group function in a subquery. In the parenthesis
group by function or having function is not
and
a
this
multiple
group function subquery. Output as a subquery,
it is a single
group
for
the main query.
When we here executed the example, you can also understand
and
the basic
you can
concept
see
of
this is the main query.
Query. Sorry.
And we uses the group function that select minimum salary from employees, and this is the 2500. And select last name, job ID, salary from employees where salary is equal to 2500. Means we want to fetch the employees last name, job ID, salary whose salary is equal to 2500. So when we executing this, we are executing this query on the SQL prompt, and you can see select last name, job ID, salary from employees where salary equal to select minimum salary from employees. Here when we are executing this query, we got Olson, it is the job ID ST clerk, and salary is equal to 2100. Here we give the group functions, but we get only one output. Here we seen the having clause with subquery. We will see the having clause. The Oracle server executed these subqueries first. It's not only basis for having clause, it's in all the terms. Parenthesis query have the highest priority than the main query. So Oracle interpreter uses to encode subquery first. Here this is the example of having clause, select department ID minimum salary from employees, group by department ID, having minimum salary is greater than, select minimum salary from employees where department ID is equal to 50. Here when we executed this query, this is the purely based on group functions, because we have the group function in main query as well as subquery, and we are also using the having clause in it. So when we executing this query on this, we got this. When we executed the having clause subquery, we seen the subquery is executed first, either it is the group function or not having a single function. Here we see another symptom, that is if inner row or inner subquery having no input or no output, then it returns no input. It means if subquery gives null value, then the main query also give null value. Here you can see this. When we given the subquery like select job ID from employees where last name is equal to Hans, there is no employee which has a last name Hans, so it returns null value. It returns null, and when it gives the output as null, then the main query executed and it also returns null value. There are three types of multiple row subqueries. In multiple row subqueries, there are three operators we generally use. The first is in operator, equal to any member in the list. Any operator must be preceding by these operators, and all must be preceding by these operators. And it compares the value in the list returned by your query. And in any and all, it gives false and it gives true. Here we seen the each example through these operators. Here we write a query, select last name Seldi, department ID from employees, where Seldi in. Select minimum salary from employees, group by department ID, and we executed this query. And here we uses in group operator as a multiple row subquery. And when we executed this, we got a multiple row subqueries output. This is the example of any operator in multiple row subquery. We use select employee ID, last name, job ID, salary from employees, where salary is less than any. It means we use the data of employees where it is less than any of one. It means it is less than 9000, it is less than 6000, and it is also less than 4200. So when we uses this, we executed this query and we got this. Here you can see this, any of these conditions is satisfied. When we use the any group subqueries, then it gives any of the condition is fully satisfied, anyone. While when we use all operator, here you can see the all operator in multiple row subquery, it when we use the all instead of n in the same subquery, then it takes all the conditions is fully satisfied in each output. When we executed this query again in the same pattern, then this query written in this format, it means the all conditions in the same query is fully satisfied. Here we completed the chapter of subqueries. This is the basic and the very easiest way to use the subqueries. We can use subqueries at many places when we want to know the when we want to use the subqueries at two place. We give when we want to use the conditions at two place, and we can use these conditions in a main query and as well as subquery. So thank you for watching our videos. Please subscribe, like and comment our videos. Thank you.